quarantine's really starting to get to me. I've got too many projects and not enough resources. So the next project that we are on is the car lift. This is the car lift that's been bought for restoration or scrap or whatever you want to call it. It came here in a bundle of bits on the back of a loader. So it needs an awful lot of work, but we're going to try and get it fixed up and running. First job is get the rollers out of the main assemblies. All the safety catches are all off, but naturally, because it's been sitting outside for the past 5 years, they're jammed. So, port of power out, port of power in, and we'll jack the end off. Well, here's where we are today. I've got the two posts stripped off, all the parts out. Today's job is to strip the carriages off and free everything up and then power hose the posts to get them ready for painting. Oh no!
Went to bed there. Yeah, you give it. You give it more, you actually do.
So our chain is soaking in a mix of diesel oil and hydraulic fluid, and the next thing we have to do with that is take it out of this drum and hammer every link, or at least check every link's free, and then put it back in the lift. Okay, so we're starting to put everything back together now. That side of the lift has been painted. This side has needed a little bit more remedial work. So there was an awful bad bend in the top. That's now been straightened out and the hole's lined up. There was a kink here, so what we've done is we've cut the kink out. And weld the plate over the top of that to keep the chain safe. Both these end plates were bent as well. I'm guessing that the guy that took the lift down tried to lower it in one piece and it fell. So they're all straightened up. Once I get this welded back in, we'll start to put everything back together once it's all painted.
Where's the boy? What? Did you bring down what? Oh, good bear. Get that laid down. One bear. Just chain to put on first, nearly, I would think.
Where's the wee spacer?
You got the wee spacer.
Good.
Ah, there, sort of there.
No, but there were spacers for these. I had them on my hand when I came out.
No, well then. You may go back on again, do with them.
There's a pin.
Had it in your hand, you come out.
I thought
I'd
come out.
No, you haven't really much, then. There you go. I was thinking you would.
Right, flying
now, we're waiting. Ah, we're in the ash. Look down that trolley, you can see it.
Get that
in the back way, then,
just
where you're
off,
you know. Or did that get the chain that way?
I think it's in first, and then...
Oh,
I
run her in.
No.
No.
So,
yeah, you're not getting down, key that way.
You put it in before you put the bow on.
Oh, that's all right.
That's a problem.
Then,
no.
Yeah, What size is that hole, Lou?
2 millimeters.
2 millimeters, that's the next thing. Right. Which way that's the odds?
Don't think it matters.
You put your knees on the outside of them, would you?
Right. Raise them up and make sure you turn the degrees on the top of the finger. And then this boy here needs a lot of grease.
Good boy.
A little grease in that there.
What side you put them on, Moody?
Aye, that side goes out and the yellow side goes in.
Yellow side goes in the gad?
Aye, plenty of grease in the yellow side.
So you put the yellow side in?
Aye.
Yeah, we're grazing away here.
Happening, Martin?
Who
bought it? Huh?
Well, it's the end of another day. That's the two columns back together now. Lift sensor and the trigger for releasing the safety mechanisms in. Ram's in. That carriage is in. Carriage is on this side as well. And the chain is in. Tops are painted. Arms are painted. The whole thing's ready to install. Once it's installed, we'll put the arms back in the carriages, but for that we're gonna have to wait for another video. See you soon.